Hello friends, today let us talk about most symmetric object that we study in mathematics. Do you know what it is? Yes, it is circle. What do we mean by a circle? Circle means all points on the paper which are at fixed distance from a certain point. Take a point A on a piece of paper. Plot a point on paper and name it A. Let's take distance of 4 cm in compass. Place one arm of compass on point A and draw a circle. We call A to be the center of circle, and as distance of each point on circle from its center, that is from A, is fixed, 4 cm in this case, we say radius of this circle is 4 cm. Let us take two points P and Q on this circle. Join P and Q by a straight line segment. We say that PQ is a chord of circle. In general, a straight line segment joining any two points on the circle is called chord of the circle. For example, all of these are chords of the circle. If a chord of circle passes through center of the circle, we call it diameter of the circle. Here, we know that distance between A and P, as well as distance between A and Q, is 4 cm. Also, as P, A, Q are collinear points, distance between P and Q is 4 plus 4 equal to 8 cm, since they are on opposite sides of A. Hence, length of diameter PQ is 8 cm. Observe that this will happen to any diameter of the circle, that is, length of any diameter of the circle is 8 cm. In general, length of diameter is twice the radius of circle. As in case of a triangle or square, its perimeter is equal to sum of lengths of all of its sides. For circle, we define its circumference to be length of the circle. If we measure circumference and diameter for different circles, we find that the ratio of circumference and diameter for any circle is a constant number. We represent this constant number by a Greek letter pi. Its value is between 3 and 4, near to 22/7 and 3.14. Search for circular objects near you and try to find value of pi approximately. Now, let us take two points P and Q on circle as before. The portion of circle between these two points is called arc of the circle. But here, using points P and Q, we can obtain two arcs, which are PQ and PQ. Hence, it is not clear if we represent an arc using just its endpoints. To resolve this, we take one more point on arc and represent the arc by using these three points. For example, we will call this arc as arc PDQ, and we will call this arc as arc PCQ. Isn't this simpler? Among these two arcs, we call the smaller arc to be minor arc and larger arc to be major arc. That is, in this case, the arc PDQ is minor arc and arc PCQ is major arc. Observe that if we fix two points on a circle, then the minor and major arcs so formed cover the whole circle. For an arc of a circle, we define its measure to be the central angle of the arc. That is, for arc PDQ, its measure is measure of smaller angle PAQ as shown. And for arc PCQ, its measure is the measure of larger angle PAQ as shown. Now a question for you. What will be the sum of measure of arc PDQ and measure of arc PCQ? Try to find out.